Guy Joseph says the Ministry of Infrastructure has adopted a piecemeal approach to addressing the plight of the people in his constituency. Mr. Joseph made the accusation as he made his rounds in the constituency and observed there was no equipment working when there is so much work to be done. The MP showed us a river in the Marc area where there is still a lot of silt. He fears that just a little more rain and the river banks will be overflowing yet again. Mr. Joseph strongly believes that constituents are being victimized because of their political affiliation.
And these are the same people who, when they were in opposition, found every avenue to criticize us after Thomas. And here I am seeing the response to this storm, and I'm seeing that the government is, it appears that they are clueless as to what to do, especially the Ministry of Infrastructure. Because if you look at the drains along the highway, most of them are still clogged. The water is not flowing. The water is stagnant in so many areas. By now, we should have seen a greater effort in clearing the drains, because the likelihood of more rain is possible. We are just in January. We are not to say that we are in the dry season. And with the weather patterns, are we going to wait until there is another disaster to try and respond to it?
According to Mr. Joseph, the Prime Minister visited the area this week, and he's hoping that some good can come out of that visit. With dengue fever in the air, as well as the real possibility of an outbreak of waterborne diseases, Mr. Joseph is in the process of delivering 200 cases of water to constituents at his expense. He made reference to two containers of water which, according to him, were unaccounted for and which he understands to be in Vieux-Fort. The parliamentary representative wants to find out what happened to the two containers.
But I have a serious concern, because I'm hearing that two 40-foot containers of water came in and nobody can account for it. I understood that vehicles actually went to collect water in Vieux-Fort and the vehicles came back up empty. My concern is, why is Bexon being treated the way that it is treated? Because after Hurricane Thomas, there was no discrimination based on political party or which parliamentarian represented an area. Everywhere that was affected was given the due attention. And the parliamentary rep for Soufre at the time, Mr. Dalson, can testify to the fact that, and he's on record saying how pleased he was with the response by the government towards what happened in Soufre.
People in the constituency lost their possessions during a trough that appeared to take the island by surprise. The trough inflicted severe damage to the infrastructure. It also left hundreds of people stranded in town and claimed six lives. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.